In this session, we're going to be working with grouping and ungrouping content blocks in WordPress. Grouping content blocks is simply taking a group of content blocks, meaning more than one, and then combining them so that they're one block. And once they're one block, it's a lot easier to manipulate. You can move it as a unit, you can give it a background color, or give it a specific text attributes. You can give it a named anchor, which we'll discuss later in this session. You can add a bit of CSS or cascading style sheets to that group, or you can use it as a reusable block where you can easily take this group of blocks and add them to any page on your site with one click. So let's begin. I'm going to add a set of content blocks to this page, and then we'll group them. And here are our three content blocks. We have an H2 header. We have an image, and we have a one-sentence paragraph with a link just below that. Let's group these next. One of the ways to group several content blocks together is to select your first content block, hold down Shift, and select your others. As a helpful hint, when you're working with a paragraph or header content block, clicking to the right of the actual text is the easiest way to select. Once they're all selected, go to this icon up here, which allows you to change the type of block you're working with and turn this into a group block. And we can now tell by this blue line bounding our three content blocks that we've turned this into one content block. If I go back into my page, I can select the individual elements of my content blocks within this group. If I want to select the entire group again, I use the Block Navigator right here, which is a really useful tool when you're working with grouping and ungrouping blocks. So if I click this, I can see the structure of my page within this group. I've got a heading, an image, and a paragraph. And if I click group, it will select the entire group for me. I can then ungroup it using this more option, three dots, and choose ungroup. And we're now back to where we started. Another way to group a set of content blocks together is to select your first content block and then change it to a group before you add your other elements. So we go over here to this transform icon and we change this into a group. We now have that plus that allows us to add another block within our bounding lines of this block. So I can click this plus and choose image and then go to my media library and choose my image. I'll size this down and continue. We now have a plus here within our bounding lines. So I'll click this plus, I'll choose paragraph, and then I will control and V in the text I had previously. So there is another way of creating a group of content blocks. I'll show you one more method and then we'll move on. I'm going to go back to my Block Navigator here and get rid of my group by choosing the group and then moving to these three dots that allows me to ungroup. This time, I'm going to select my first element. I'm going to choose Control and Shift, and I'm going to select my last element. And that also chooses all three of my elements. And from here, I can change this into a group block. So now that we have a group of content blocks, let's see what we can do with them. I'm first going to select the entire group by going to my Block Navigator and choosing group. And that bounding blue line lets us know we've chosen a group. Now if we go over here to the right pane under our block commands, we have several options under color settings and under advanced. Let's start with color settings. I can change my text color right here, and this is the text color for the entire group, not just a specific text block within it. So we'll choose something fairly chill. So I can change my text color that way. I can change the background color of the entire block using this tool. And these are solid colors, but if I go to gradient, I can actually choose a two-color gradient, as we see here. I can change the type from linear to a circle in the center of our page. I can work with the angle of the gradient and where it shows up on my gradient and so on. So that's our work with gradients. I think we will go back and choose group here, and we're going to change this to a solid color and continue. So here is a solid background color on our group. Let's move down to advanced. Here's the HTML anchor. HTML anchors in the olden days, we used to call named anchors, and what it allows you to do is to link from one part of your page to another part of your page. We're going to call this group newsletter. So now this group can be linked to simply by a link that uses pound and newsletter. Let's quickly do this and then we'll move on. So let's see how this HTML anchor works. I've added some things to the page, a bit of link text right here, and then some filler text right here, and then my group of content blocks is right down here. So what I want to do is create a link from here to here. Remember that, and I'll go to my Block Navigator here. When I choose the group, I can see that my HTML anchor is newsletter. So let's create a link to this HTML anchor. Very easy to do. I go to this text up here, and then I'm going to create a link, and that link is going to be the pound symbol, and then whatever I called my anchor, my HTML anchor, in this case, newsletter. I'll hit the submit option. We now have a link here, and let's see if it actually does link to our sustainable gardening newsletter group block right here. I'll click preview, and here's a preview of the page. When I click my link, it takes me directly to my sustainable gardening newsletter set of blocks. One more trick, and then we'll call it a day. We can take our group here, our set of three content blocks, and turn this into a reusable block. If this is a bit of information you're going to be using on several of your pages, this might be something you want to put into a reusable block so you can easily reuse it onto a page. The way to turn it into a reusable block is simply to select your group, then go to your three dots right here, choose Add to Reusable Blocks. We'll call this newsletter subscribe block. And we now, as soon as I add the in to newsletter, we now have a reusable block we can put on any page. The way to add it to a page is to go to a icon letting you add a block. We can then put in the first few letters of newsletter, and we see our reusable block here. We select it, and that is how to add a reusable block to an existing page. Be aware, if you change any part of your reusable block, it's going to change all the other reusable blocks in your site as well. So if you want to change the text or any of the content in a reusable block, you need to first select the block and then turn it into convert to regular block. And that will allow you to edit this reusable block, or this formerly reusable block, without affecting the others. And that is how to work with the basics of grouping and ungrouping in WordPress.